We can inside, but. Okay.
Are you guys ready?
Yeah!
All right.
Had no idea what was going on, but what I did know is that I had a best friend that anyone could ask for, and he also happened to be my brother. Now, one of the most proud moments that I have of Rob is that something totally weird happened. My brother Rob took a pledge. He pledged to earn hundreds of more brothers and sisters. And you see, there are those that run away from problems and those that run towards them. And I just want to give a round of applause, if you could see on the screen, and please have all the firemen, firefighters, please stand up. Please stand up.
Thank you for all that you do for us and protecting us.
I'm the youngest of three, so I have Naha and I have Karim. And, you know, as the youngest of three, I had your typical sibling dynamic, so The typical older one who was like super protective, kept track of me, told me I'd be forever 13, right? But it was great because I had the more relaxed one, the one who was laid back, one who was, you know, just kind of there. It was great. Now, what may be surprising is that the protective one was Noha, not Gutty.
Noha and her family are probably some of the most caring people that I know. And I might get a little bit embarrassing here, but that's what I do. Mrs. Georges, I am still trying to burn off all of the calories that you feed me whenever I come over. And I especially love you, and I smile, grin ear to ear when you call me Hibby Bit. Mr. Georges, not only are you one of the best huggers, he's kind of like a teddy bear, but one of the best moments that I love about Mr. Georges is we came home from, I think it was either Noha's birthday party or graduation party. Either way, Robert and I had to sleep over because we were a little under the weather. And about 9:30 in the morning, Mrs. Georges cooks this amazing breakfast, and Mr. Georges just decides to, you know, swip some bourbon right in front of our nose. It's really a good thing that they have 100 bathrooms in their house.
So, Robbie, the day you came into the picture, I knew a little bit about you. You know, I had heard about you, but Noha brought you home for dinner, and I knew it was serious because she turned bright red. She was so nervous. She was looking around like, you know, is he going to get along with everyone? Or is he going to like him? And, of course, we had our own little test. I would say something sarcastic, see what he said. You know, I'd say a joke, be like, is he going to laugh? Obviously. And then I knew, you know, I knew he was going to fit right in when he outdid all of my tasks. So I was like, all right, you know, I'll give you approval. It's fine. But there was one moment where I was like, nope, this is the one. He saw me and Noha sing Bohemian Rhapsody word for word, followed by interpretive dance, and then he came back. So I was like, all right, this guy's in for the long haul, all right?
When Rob told us that he was going to propose to Noha, we were having coffee with my dad, which is a pretty emotional time for us. My dad and I were shocked because we didn't think Noha would actually say yes, but... You see, we just lost my dad, or our dad, a mere 6 months ago, and I feel as if I haven't seen him in decades. But the truth is, Dad is living through us every single day. I guarantee he is here with us right now. He validates that his spirit is watching over us by leaving little clues. Like, for example, today we were taking pictures and somehow bacon-wrapped scallops came up perfectly. Or every time I pick up this Coors Light, it just slowly disappears. I don't get it. Somewhere out there, he's laughing and he's dancing. But most importantly, he's smiling because he's the most proud he could be right now for you two. Just as I am seeing my biggest hero. Just as I am the most proud seeing my biggest hero and my idol start this covenant of their lifelong union together.
Noha and Robbie, I love you guys. I'm so happy for you. Robbie, I'm so glad I gained a brother today.
Noha, your husband is a very special person, and he still likes to play with fire trucks.
So Robbie, today, what's today, April 28th? It marks the day of years of off-key singing and awful dancing, absurd dancing, and endless episodes of Friends ahead. Congratulations. Woo! Cheers.
Rob and Noha. Mabruk.
First time I met Robbie, he came over for dinner.
She said, Mom, somebody's coming to see me. And when he walked in, she blushed.
And then she was just looking around like, oh, I don't know what's gonna happen. And then Mom comes in, and it was just like a really tense moment. And I was like, hi, honey, how are you? And then Noha's face is just relief.
The minute I saw her face, I know that she's in love with him.
We would always have coffee with my dad, which was a pretty emotional thing. And the three of us were sitting down, having coffee, you know, just exploring life's problems. And he just said, you know what, this is gonna happen. I'm gonna I'm gonna propose to Noha.
Robbie asked my dad for Noha's hand.
They came to my house to show me the ring and announce their engagement. She FaceTimed me at 11 p.m. and we were, you know, we bounced out of bed and it was like the best story ever. So she like showed me the ring. I was like, but then she said shh, because she wanted to also show cream, so I tried to like not. She just has a loving heart and just loved her immediately. So to see them get married today was wonderful and so happy for them.
Do you think Noha here a present for your wife? Louder, louder. Noha, my beloved daughter, do you think Robert here a present for your husband?
So make a prediction. What do you think is going to be the most insane thing that happens tonight?
Whatever performance or surprise he has planned, I don't know what it is, but I think that's going to be pretty phenomenal.
Yeah.
Do you know what it is?
I played the fifth.
You played the fifth? I like that. I think it's going to be amazing.
You didn't know all the ways I love you. No, you changed the plan. And she didn't think it would come crashing down. No,
you don't have to say what you did.
What you did.
You and me will never be.
Present from the family of the bride. God, will you bring the music of her first love right here to this dance floor? Get off your seats, get on your feet, and let's dance along. Sing it with me. Are you comfortable?
Right there, right there.
Let the groove get in.
There, there, right there.
Are you comfortable?
Right there, right there.
Let the groove get in. You dance, 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 dance
Okay, Mark and Vandellas will be coming back at you later in the show. Right now we turn our attention to the Soul Train gang, the Soul Train line, the master storyteller, Mr. Curtis Mayfield.
Take my shot.